Good evening. Welcome to St. Thomas More. Thank you for joining us for Mass. We have these announcements. Grades K through 8 religious education registration materials are now available in the gathering space and on our parish website. If you have questions or if you are interested in being a K through 8 religious ed catechist, please contact Shannon Duffy in our parish office. Registration for high school students wanting to prepare for the Sacrament of Confirmation this year is now available. Go to the link on our parish website to sign up. Contact Angie Goodwin in the parish office if you have questions. Calling all young adults ages 21 through 39, are you looking for a vibrant community to connect with and grow in faith? Join us for a special potluck dinner this Thursday, June 27th at 7 p.m. Bring any side dish or dessert to share. We'll share a meal together and dive into exciting discussions about upcoming events and invitations tailored especially for young adults. Our Growing More in Faith campaign challenge to reach 12 million in pledges by the end of June is progressing well. With a week to go, we have just under 450,000 to reach our goal. Plan to attend an informal concert by Luigi Enriquez and friends at 3 p.m. next Sunday here in church. Refreshments will be provided and proceeds from a free will donation will go to advance our Growing More in Faith goal. All are welcome to an enjoyable time of music, fellowship, and fun. Now please stand and greet those around you as we prepare for Mass.
Do not let your hearts be troubled, children, do not fear. Though you suffer as I suffer, I am always near. Come to the Lord, come to the table of lasting life, bring your burdens, there is no pride. Come to the Lord. I will never leave you, orphans. You are not alone. I have made your place in heaven, in my Father's home. Come to the Lord. Come to the table of lasting life. Bring your burdens, there is no price, just come to the Lord.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Let's come together in prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
June 22nd is the feast of St. Thomas More, so this weekend at Masses, we're celebrating Thomas More, our parish patron. Thomas More, martyr and great scholar and great man of conscience. Let's acknowledge our sins as we prepare for this celebration and come to know God's mercy and love. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy. You give us yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus. glory of God the Father. Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of
let us pray. O God, who in martyrdom have brought true faith to its highest expression, graciously grant that, strengthened through the intercession of Saints John Fisher and Thomas More, we may confirm by the witness of our life the faith we profess with our lips. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you, Scarlett.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be sealed.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. Everlasting. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. Everlasting. Give thanks, for the Lord is good. Give thanks to the God of gods. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. Everlasting. Who alone does wonderful things? Who alone made the heavens in wisdom? Who alone spread the earth on the waters? God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting. God's love is everlasting.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us, once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Speak, O Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat just as he was, and other boats were with him. A violent squall came up and waves were breaking over the boat so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
We have a handful of young people that are going to go to Notre Dame, South Bend, tomorrow and spend the week in what's called Notre Dame Vision, a nice little leadership training for youth, a wonderful opportunity. I don't know if it was because they're going to Notre Dame or the readings themselves, but it reminded me of the movie Rudy. There's a wonderful scene in the movie Rudy where this young man who tries hard as he can to become a football player for Notre Dame for the Fighting Irish, and he isn't even a student there yet, and he works and he becomes so frustrated that there's a scene where he finds himself talking to the priest, an elderly priest who happens, I think, in real life was supposed to be the president of University of Notre Dame, Father Kavanaugh. But anyway, after he pours out his heart to the priest and tells him all of his problems, the priest has this wonderful line. He says, "In all my many years of theological study, I've come up with only two hard facts that I can say with absolute certainty. One, there is a God. Two, I'm not him. It's a great line. And you know what? I think it's almost exactly the answer that God gives Job in that first reading. Job, of course you know the story. Job has experienced every kind of trial in life. Job rails at God because of the suffering that he's enduring, questions God's wisdom and power. Job's experienced the loss of family, the loss of his livelihood, and he develops these awful boils on his body. He's got a right to complain to God. But what does God say to him? Where were you when I created the earth? Who has the power to calm the sea? Who created the earth and its beauty? And that's just, what's God saying? I'm God, you're not. Be still and know that I'm God. And what does Job do? The next part of the passage, Job humbly kneels in adoration of God. And he goes off as a very faithful follower of Jesus. A follower of God. The story ends much happier, but the story of Job's life and his pain and his problems, you know, it's not all that different than the disciples in the boat. They're saying to Jesus, why don't you do something? We're going to perish. They're afraid. And there Jesus is sound asleep. And it's the same thing that we probably say when we experience storms and trials of every kind, the loss of loved ones, storms of misunderstanding, maybe financial health worries. Don't we say, Lord, are you asleep? Don't you care that we're perishing? As Job found out, the only answer really is this. I'm with you. I'm with you. Period. And that's enough. We commemorate St. Thomas More this weekend. Thomas More certainly experienced trials in life. Thomas More was a layperson, which makes him such a wonderful role model for so many of us, or you who are laypersons, not priests or religious. He was the father of four children, ahead of his time in the sense that at a time when only male children were educated, he insisted on his daughters being educated as well. A scholar, writer, lawyer, so honest and trustworthy that he became chancellor to King Henry VIII and looked upon to many for his honesty. But as chancellor, he was pressured by King Henry VIII to sign the separation agreement of the Catholic Church, making Henry VIII the leader of the Church of England, separating themselves from the papacy. And More chose not to go along just because everybody else was, but to stay true to his conscience and his faith, led to his eventual imprisonment and finally his execution, beheaded. What allowed Thomas More to be so true to his faith? When all people around him, they showed him a list of all of his colleagues and friends that had signed the agreement, he refused. He was a man of conscience. And it makes him also a good role model in so many ways, a time where so many people want to just fall in line with ideologies that are so foreign to what is true and what is true to our faith. He never let his faith take a back seat to his words and his life. And he said this, his last words were, I die the king's good servant. He was loyal to the king, but I'm God's servant first. God's servant first. What a storm Thomas More went through. In many ways, he was kind of like Jesus and the disciples. He calmly endured a year of imprisonment in the Tower of London. He is said to have even joked When the time came for him to be executed, he joked with his executioner. He had a sense of humor. There's a wonderful prayer of good humor that he prayed that actually Pope Francis has said is one of his favorites. Maybe it's that humor that is a wonderful sign of his trust in God, even amid the storms of life. Thomas More, maybe he heard Jesus say, "Why are you afraid? Do you not yet have faith?" Well, today let's allow Jesus' words to resonate in our hearts. Let's tune out the voices that would lead us to fear and allow our trust in God to make us people of good conscience, people of conviction, not swayed by forces down a wrong road. Let's hear Jesus say what he said to the storm, "Quiet, be still." And let's be thankful that God is God and that we're not. And be thankful that Jesus is still in our boat. We stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made. For us and our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We turn to God our Father with hearts full of faith, presenting our needs and the needs of our whole world, trusting in God's infinite mercy.
For the church, that she may remain steadfast in faith, courageous in proclaiming the gospel, and unwavering in her mission to uphold truth and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family on the feast of our patron, that through the intercession of St. Thomas More, we may grow in holiness, unity, and service to one another and to all those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a calming of the storms in our lives, that God will sustain us through the challenges of each day and give us courage and strength to overcome all fear. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, that God will heal those dealing with serious illness and strengthen their caregivers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for an end to violence, that God will turn hearts from violence and protect all innocent people from injury. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we pause to bring to God in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, hear our prayers, and through the intercession of St. Thomas More, grant us the grace to follow his example of fidelity to conscience and to truth. May our lives be a testimony to your love, your mercy, your peace. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Be still and know that I am God. You are my chosen one to whom my love I give. My life is yours, in you I live. Be still, be still.
Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We offer you sacrificial gifts, O Lord, to commemorate your blessed martyr, Thomas More, whom no temptation could separate from unity of the body of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly, it is right and just, our duty, our salvation at all times, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr, Thomas More, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows your marvelous works by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble you bestow strength to bear you witness. So with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving you thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with all of our bishops, clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Thomas More, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Formed by divine teaching and at the Savior's own command, we now can pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from all evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Look not on our sinfulness, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share that peace with each other. Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Just you.
Let us pray. Made new by these sacred mysteries, we pray, O Lord, that imitating the wondrous constancy of Blessed Thomas More, we may merit an eternal reward for suffering endured through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace, glorifying God by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Let us live our lives so that all might see that our hearts are restless till they rest in thee. Let us build your kingdom in truth and grace so that all might know they have a rightful place. Beauty ever ancient and breaking through our deafness so we hear you, shattering the darkness of night. A new dawn is rising to bring your light to all. Together in your presence we came to be one in spirit and truth and name, strengthened by the body of Christ, taking up the call now to share your light with all the